everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are curing garlic for winter. Some of you may have seen us when we dug up our garlic, then we let it sit for about 2 weeks so far, and now we're going to prepare it to take it indoors to finish curing and then down to the basement to spend the winter. So this is how they look now. Dead. They look like they're dead, but they aren't, because inside there is the yummy garlic. And do you see how this outer membrane has now turned to paper? And that is so cool. Obviously, this one is a purple stripe.
Now, I notice some of your viewers ask why you kept these long stems and roots and everything.
Cut them right away. Well, in the curing process, there's still energy left in the stalk and the leaves. And while they're, you know, not getting any more soil nutrients, some of that nutrient can go back down into the bulb itself, and it just adds to the perhaps flavor.
At least that's your experimental theory.
That is my theory. So when in the research we've done, this is what you do. And now it's time to trim it and also trim off these roots. When you see them in the store, they don't have these roots on. And they don't have a long stem either. So that's what we're going to take off today.
Now, you have two types of garlic that you've grown this year.
I do. I have this German purple striped garlic. It's a hard neck, which means this part is hard. And it goes all the way down to the root.
So the soft neck you'd see more in a southern climate,
yes,
where you see them woven together in clusters,
mm-hmm,
hanging.
Yes. This lasts longer as far as storing for the winter.
The hard neck?
Yes.
As opposed to soft neck?
As opposed to soft neck, yes.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
Yes. And the porcelain is going to be the same thing. Let me see if I can find a porcelain. I believe this is a porcelain. And you can see this one, no purple stripes. And it looks more bulbous. Porcelain, I have found, has bigger cloves. Less work when you get to use it. And we really like the flavor of it.
Would it have fewer cloves because it's bigger?
It has fewer cloves, yes.
Fewer cloves.
Yes. It has fewer cloves. And it was very, very flavorful. We liked it. Garlic is such a great vegetable to plant. I'm going to call it a vegetable because it's a one-time investment. You buy your bulbs initially from a grower. Don't use the ones in the store. Get them from a grower, either a farmer that's growing them and you can get it at the farmer's market, or go to a garden center. Get the garlic that's ready to be planted.
So it's specifically garlic that is used as a seed crop.
Correct. Okay. The neat thing about garlic is you buy it once. Now, let's say this was the one I bought. Now, I can take this apart then, and I'll have 8 to 10 cloves to plant in the ground. Each one is going to grow, and each one is going to have 8 to 10 more cloves in the summer when you pull it up. So there you already have a whole row, and you don't have to buy another one because you already have them. Now, what we have found is that because of our inoculation, because of how we keep track of them, we decide which ones we want to save and use for seed. Obviously, we're going to take the biggest ones, because perhaps the biggest ones will give us the biggest ones next year. So we divide, at this point, we're going to divide our seed ones as opposed to the ones we're going to eat or share. Garlic is really a good crop to grow anywhere in your garden. If you have deer problems, you could plant garlic in the fall next to your tulips. And the garlic, when it comes up, will keep the deer away. They don't like garlic. Rabbits don't like garlic.
Well, they don't like the smell of it.
Correct. And if they take a bite of it, they'll like it even less. So that's one reason to plant it. Another is it seems to be a good companion to any plant, that it just either gives off good vibes or good nutrients or something in the soil, and plants do well when they're planted near garlic.
Well, when you harvested all the garlic, you were researching something about what it did to the soil, too.
Yes, it improves the soil. It's just good for all-around gardening. And when you pull it up, obviously, you have a delicious thing to put into your food.
I mean, it's good for you. We've been eating garlic for many, many years, but I was still amazed at all the health benefits, too, that doctors and and researchers have found that garlic offers.
It's good for your gut microbes. It's good for your
cholesterol,
high
blood pressure, a whole bunch of things.
Keeps the vampires away.
Didn't help with me, though, did it?
You are not a vampire.
Oh.
Do I have to tell you that?
I want to drink your blood.
No. Now, I'm using my regular trimmers that I use all over the yard. And while, yes, I am trimming off things that have soil on them, there are things that we've trimmed as far as weeds go that could possibly be poisonous. Like, let's say we were going to be trimming the monk's hood. That is a poisonous plant. So I have taken extra care to wash the scissors and use alcohol on them.
So you sterilized the tools.
I did.
Which is always a good idea. Why transfer disease from one plant to another?
Well, that, and we don't want to be eating that either.
True.
So if I clip this off and somehow, not that I'm going to eat these roots, but for some reason I got monk's hood juice on here and it transferred to here and then we ate it, it wouldn't be good. So this is my finished product now. It has the white paper on it, the roots are trimmed, the stem is trimmed.
It smells like garlic.
So instead of taking one garlic and doing both things, because then I'd have to switch my tools, what I'm going to do is I'll snip off the tops first, and then I'll come back and snip off the roots. Now, if the paper seems like it wants to come off, I take it off. If it doesn't want to come off, I just leave it alone. Now, when we used to make paper in our art school days, this paper would have been something we would add to the mash that would add a texture.
Well, all of these stems too, we would soak them in water and then oysterize them and get that mash.
Yep.
And then our screen, we'd lay out sheets of paper and then press flower petals.
Oh, you lay out the mash. Yeah. And then if you wanted to embed something in the paper for an artistic purpose, like a violet flower or a dainty leaf, then you would put that on top of the mash, and then you would put your blotter paper, and then you would press it down.
That was a cool process. I always enjoyed that. Until we got into marbling paper, that was even cooler.
Right. But remember when we talked about hibiscus? They use the stalks because they're fibrous to make paper.
Yeah.
I never thought of that.
Well, anything from nature can be recycled, so.
Or decomposed.
Yeah. Well, this will head to our compost bin. But look at all these little flower heads that we never cut off. The seed heads, I should say. The seed pods.
Escapes that escape. This is what happens if you don't catch the scapes early enough.
And we thought we got them all. Silly us.
We missed 10 to 12.
Oh, yeah, at least.
saved two of the biggies for the last. So it doesn't take long to do this. Just pick a nice day that's pleasant for you and dry outside.
That was amazing. The last week has been so nice here. I mean, this is more typical, I guess, of Wisconsin weather.
Well, this is what we always look forward to all winter.
Yes.
Less humid, but still warm. And that's how it's been all week. And so we were able to come out and do things that we couldn't do the last 2 weeks because it was just so humid. And that's what's coming tomorrow and the weekend. Okay. So here is our last one. What a beauty.
Mm-hmm.
I would say that's a purple, wouldn't you?
Yep.
And here is our
bounty
stash. Yep. Smaller ones here, bigger ones here. So now it's a matter of sorting through them, deciding which ones we want for our seeds, which ones we're going to keep for storage. And some of them we can give away right now, some of these littler ones. So you use a whole bulb when you're cooking something, that's fine too. Now, we were talking about the seeds. This is the scape that came out of the garlic plant itself. These obviously are all the flowers, and underneath, if you look down between those, these little purple parts, these are the baby garlic cloves that will start new garlic plants.
Oh, that's really a seed, the seed pod.
Yes.
So you can grow garlic either from a seed or from a clove.
You can. It's just obviously much faster if you grow it from a clove, which is at least this big itself rather than this big.
True. It's like a tooth, like a little baby tooth, the dog tooth.
Our friends Scott and Sarah just sent us a surprise in the mail called an Egyptian onion, which is a walking onion plant. So you plant the little cloves that grow under the ground and stay there, and then their stalk goes up like a scape does, falls over from the weight of it, and seeds itself or plants itself. And so the next year, not only will you have your original starting point, but you'll have a little bunch over here. Or a little bunch over here. So it's, thanks guys, it was fun to get in the mail. We'll give it a try. And they said, put it in with your flowers. It'll be neat. It'll just walk around your whole flower bed if you wanted to.
Yeah, well, we're also going to add music garlic next year,
yes,
as well, which is another form of porcelain.
Does it play songs?
Yes, it sings to you. And it does a lot of loud music to keep
the deer
and the antelope.
Yes. It is called music, though, and it's related to the porcelain. It's in the porcelain garlic family.
But larger, it's a larger bulb with fewer cloves. I think it only has maybe 4 to 6 cloves in it, but they're really big. And
you ordered some, right?
I ordered you 2 pounds of them.
Whoa!
So I'm anxious to see how those do with your porcelain and your German purple striped hardneck that you have. So I think those three will be a nice combination. Plus, the music garlic is the one that the gourmet chefs prefer to use themselves. So
because it's so big and they only have to do 1 or 2 rather than 5 or 6.
And extremely flavorful.
Wonderful.
So
looking forward to it.
Yep.
Again, you would plant that in the fall, correct?
Yep.
Just like a tulip.
Yeah.
Well, now we just have to decide which ones we're going to keep for our seeds. It'll be big ones. This is a purple one, and we'll use a porcelain one as well. We'll have maybe 10 of these, and then the rest.
Each?
No, not 10 of each. Well, maybe. I don't know.
Well, yeah.
Because remember how many are in there,
yeah,
and how much garlic can a person eat. But
yeah,
anyway, we will be planting these then in our freeze zone before Halloween, so mid-October.
We're zone 5B too, as a comparison.
Right. So these will go in the ground. We'll separate them, obviously, and then each clove goes in the ground 4 inches, 4 inches apart, and they stay in the ground all winter. And then they'll pop up in the spring and be very happy plants. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We would truly appreciate that. And if you have comments or questions or tips for us, we love looking at those too. We have such great viewers. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay healthy. Want to be a subscriber? Go down here and you can become part of our garden family. We would love that too. Have a great weekend. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube and subscribe to our channel.